Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For a free of charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Hello. Before I forgot, or maybe I'll tell you later, huh? Okay, question first. I won't forget. I have it right here. Yeah. Tell me. Lynn, Ohio. How are you?
Very well. Thank you, Master.
You're new, huh?
New here.
Yeah.
Not new disciple, but
no,
new
here. Huh? Okay. Yeah. But I haven't seen you often before either.
Yeah, I kind of...
Shy.
Sit in the back, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
No. Mostly this is a good news about Loving Hut.
Uh-huh.
And first, we want to thank you most of all of your love and grace. And just so many things that are like miracles that we know are from the grace of God. So we thank you very much. And
thank you, all of you, working hard to make it happen.
It's just so rewarding because of the things that do happen that are miracles, you know.
Yes. Yeah.
Even from the customer and also just within our own operation. Everything from we think we don't have enough time to do something and somehow the time is okay and we can get it done to like if we run out of something, that might be even popular food item, suddenly customers don't order that. They order something else. So you don't have to disappoint them.
You didn't, like, advise them to order something else? No.
Okay. I mean, occasionally you have to say, sorry, we don't have it, but it's just amazing that sometimes we run out of things and people just suddenly
order change their mind. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And just in terms of the people... And the customers themselves, the ones who go vegan. Some people told us they eat there one time and then become vegetarian or vegan after that.
Wow.
And other people come in like some number of days. They report to us how many days they are vegan. Like they say, you know, up to 140.
Wow.
One guy, we're 360.
Oh.
So it's so encouraging to have
congratulations.
Those kinds of things happen,
yeah.
Too.
It's good to feel, huh? It's good to feel like your work is bearing fruits, huh?
Yes, yeah. Yes. Yeah, we really, like I say, we really
congratulations.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
And then?
I think that's about it for us. We really try to make sure that the food is as pure as possible.
Mm-hmm.
We have all non-GMO and a lot of organic and raw foods.
Mm.
That somebody went to training for a raw food chef, and so we have a whole raw food menu as well.
Very good. How do you make raw? Just salad and
well, that's
sprinkles
what, that's
some
what
stuff.
You would think, but... They made like everything from we have a raw taco supreme, we have like a raw Reuben, you know, all kinds of raw dishes that are really very tasty.
Oh.
And some of the people who are vegan...
You made it, so you say it's tasty, huh?
Actually, I don't make it. No. I only say it's tasty because I eat it.
Your people make it.
Yeah, you're right. No, but it's very popular. Even the people that don't eat raw normally, they will order some things and come back and tell us how much they enjoyed it.
Yeah,
so,
good.
Yeah, it just...
You don't like, how you say, puree it, no? Just make it on a dish.
Yeah, some ingredients might be puree before, like a pate kind of thing, or you know, guacamole that goes into the raw taco supreme, those kind of things.
Sounds yummy to me. We don't have it here, okay?
It's pretty yummy.
Okay.
Okay.
Don't keep describing because they might want it.
Well, again, it's more the customers that are so encouraging as well because they...
Wonderful. Good news indeed.
My name's Kenneth Williams. I'm the world's first vegan bodybuilder champion and national spokesperson. A 21st century athlete. If he wants to move further in his and her development, they're going to have to come to grips with eating properly.
We have the power to really, you know, imagine the future and to affect it if we want to. So
I believe we need to treat all life with incredible respect. You know,
I mean, every decision that we can make every day is going to make a difference to the planet. And
vegan diet, everybody wins, really. All the earthlings win on that one.
Shakyamuni Buddha, Jesus Christ, St. Francis of Assisi, Leonardo da Vinci, Shania Twain, Leo Tolstoy, Albert Einstein, Alicia Silverstone, Tobey Maguire, Joaquin Phoenix, Pamela Anderson. What do these distinguished people of the past and present have in common? They represent the circle of vegetarian and vegan elite and some of the most gifted and accomplished people in the world.
Follow what Mahatma Gandhi said, be the change you want to see in the world, then we have to start with ourselves. And one way that we can make a major difference is to reduce our meat consumption.
It's a win-win-win situation. It's good for the environment, it's good for people, it's good for animals.
10 billion farm animals are killed every single year in America, and that's 1 million animals per hour. That's astounding. 1 million animals per hour are slaughtered for food. That really disturbs me.
So considering all these aspects, it's better to switch to vegetarianism, which will bring back nature's harmony and has a purifying effect.
They are some of the countless noble examples of compassion and wisdom. So keep in good company with the Noble Circle of Vegetarian and Vegan Elite. And the list goes on. Please visit www.suprememastertv.com/VE for further club list and info. Choose veggie and join the club.
Thank you, Lynn.
But thank you, Master.
You look good yourself.
Thank you.
You look happy and, you know, well. And,
oh, we're just, yeah, so many
pretty.
Blessings from
that.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm so glad to be here. Thank you.
Is that why? Is that the reason? Okay, next one.
Hello, Master. Thanks for this opportunity to meet you for the first time.
Oh, really?
Yes.
It's for me, first time opportunity to see you. Thank you.
I would like also to thank the staff for the organization. I am very impressed by their efficiency, of course, and they are very pleasant.
Oh, yeah?
So I come from Paris Center. And yes,
you
and from
know.
Algeria also.
Huh. Very good. Okay, what did you do there before you come here?
Teacher, I was
a teacher.
Engineering school.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Big shot. Professor.
Yes.
Merci, Madame Professor.
Yes.
Et voilà. C'est tout?
That's all.
Okay.
That's all, Master.
Hi, Master.
Hi, again. Hi.
Hi.
A regular customer.
Yeah, thank you for this opportunity to stay here for a while.
Yes.
We humans, we lost the ability to communicate with each other telepathically. Would we be able to regain it, and would it be beneficial for us?
Yeah, some will. Some can. It's not a very important attribute, okay? We have languages, okay? We have internet. We have automatic translator. Understand? Yeah, so you just push a button, huh? No need to think, no need to meditate on who is that person thinking and what, you know. I think it's better we don't have telepathy. Because most people are thinking nonsense, bad things, and oh, not very pretty to hear or to see, yeah? And that would be more war, no? Between husband and wives, between children and parents, between teachers and students, between girlfriend and boyfriends, between dogs and dogs, between cats and cats. And between dog and cats, for example, yeah? That would be bad. That's why I think heaven took away our ability to communicate inwardly, you know, telepathically. Maybe it's a blessing in disguise. Yeah. I don't want to know what you are thinking. Please, no. I shut it. Yeah, even if I shut it, some still leaking in, you know, seeping in, and it's not always pleasant. It's better not to know too much. Is that it?
Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah. It would benefit us telepathically once our spiritual level is almost equally high. Okay? Yes. At the moment, it's better we go without. We use telephone. Yeah. Skype. Yeah. And email. Yeah? Or text. SMS. Yes, that's the kind of telepathy, you know? Telephone, party.
师父好,见到师父感觉真好,师父好美啊。哦,你好美你。谢谢师父。师父,我那个,就是今天听了前边几天的那师父的讲经,师父给了我们殊胜的力量。 师父还说，启动这些力量与我们的善念有关。那我想知道，这个力量发出去的那个大小，是不是跟念力的强弱也有关系呢？
是有关系。谢谢师父。是有关系。比方说，你跟你先生不在一起，比较遥远，然后 你电话就没功能或是没办法联络什么的 OK， 然后你在想，哎呀，如果他现在怎么能够帮我做这个那个就多好哈。然后他在遥远的地方哈，如果你很强烈想念他，强烈有这个真的是很需要那个东西，也许他收到，他莫名其妙去买那个东西给你，听懂吗？这个也不用跟修行很大的关系的，不痛外面的人他也可以这样做了，要训练 OK。 不过我们那种肯定的力量哈，是 automatic， 也是自动的，需要什么自然就来了 OK 啊。
自己不知道，
不用送什么的啊。当然祷告的话对自己也很舒服啊，比方说你认为 OK 师父什么都知道了，不过我不晓得他知不知道，也许我认为他知道，不过师父他也许不晓得他会不会认为他自己知道，所以刚好祷告跟他讲，哦，师父我今天这个那个啊，有点问题这样子，请师父帮忙这样子，听懂吗？那个的话就也不用了，是自动的哈，没有要求，如果需要的话师父也会送的，听懂吗？因为我们最好就是要求修行的方面了哈，不然的话对我们怎么好的话师父自己啊或是上帝决定就好了 OK。 你意思是这样吗？
对，就是比如说我们希望世界和平嘛，那么每个人这样想可能就是每个人想的时候跟他的念力有关，假如是师父要是说想世界和平，那跟我们一般人想肯定不一样，那个我就说这个力量的话就是有强弱吧。
也许不一样，不过多数嘛，你们多数的话也是蛮有帮助的 OK。 比方说一个人电力比较短啊，另外一个比较长，不过合在一起的话是蛮有力量啊。
就是我们打坐如果很精进很专注的话，那个念力是不是就会跟着增长？
比较强。对，
谢谢师父。
不过那个很困难哈。刚才想一个就马上就跑到那个跑到那个去。
是
师父你好。
你好。
师父很感谢你安排这么殊胜的打禅还有加持给我们，真的很开心。那师父我的问题是，师父您曾经说过您现在的等级超过1000界以上了，所以您可以不用辛苦的投胎就可以在各个星球出现，那我们往生以后根据我们所在的等级的地方就可以看到您。那真的很开心很感谢。那我的问题是，那这样说起来的话，以后地球这个星球的人是不是也可以永远看到师父？是看到肉身还是化身？我不太懂，请问师父。
这个是讲别的世界了，这个世界的话看福报啊，看那个世界人的福报 OK。 不然的话可以有别的师父来啊 OK。 这个世界不一样哦。
所以不是每一个不是宇宙中每一个星球都可以看到师父。
看哪个星球了。不过师父也可以听到了，可以知道了。就是肉身的话有别的师父啊，不需要他来这个地方。因为这个星球的话每个人轮班了。OK。物质的星球的话就用物质的方面 OK。 好了吗？没了哈。 OK good thank you for your question last time I think I forgot to tell you last time I tell you only 2 or 3 right, for example karmic immunity return love I didn't tell you disaster nullifying, Also, that was but long time already, 13th of May, and 14th of May and 15th of May and 16th of May. For example, 13th of May, disaster nullifying got 32%, and it will last for 7 years. Minimizing, huh? Minimum. So, for example, if a disaster, you know, of some kind, maybe typhoon or something, supposed to destroy all that village, then it would be less, something like that. It's not possible to completely nullify because of too much bad karma of this planet, understand? We kill more animals than all of the life existing on this planet. Yeah, and that karma is very, very burdensome. And blah, 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 a lot of things. That was those days, huh? I have a different, what do you say?
Diary.
Diary, thank you, Jean. I'm very tired today. I could hardly get up today. Mm. But I promised to come, so I come, huh? I promise at least 21st, now. Nah? So I came here just to tell you that I'm very tired. That I don't really want to come. But I promise, you know, I will try to come to the end of the month if I can, eh? And if I don't come, you know, maybe I'm dead or something, or maybe I just stuck in bed, or yeah, sit on the rediscover divine connection and it's stuck in there. Yeah, could be sucked up, you know, couldn't get out. Yeah. Last time I forgot to tell you. Okay, so many things here I can't tell you, okay? Every day I wrote something. And you can see that I use it a lot. It's all broken already. Yeah. When was the last time I... June, huh? June was the last time. I remember I told you about the bedroom, the different map, I put it here. Yeah, yeah, okay? Not in there anymore. Because I don't need this, more practical. I use this more often. This was the beginning of my time when I thought I need a big one in order to write everything down, because, you know, the whole line like this. And sometimes for a description of where the divine connection are, so I have to write down like, okay, blah, 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 where, you know? Like, produce love is in front of a garden corner next to the stone, extreme left from the pool, opposite the middle tree, called karob. This is a tree, it tastes like chocolate, karob. They use it to make, you know, similar to chocolate. And when my dog Hermit was alive, he loves it very much. I told you already. Because Lucky likes to eat it, but he's too small and short legs, he couldn't get it. And not so agile like Hermit. Hermit is a very hyper type, you know, always full of energy. And he jumps anywhere as long as there's food. Yeah, he jumps, he opens, he steals, he snacks, everything. So the trees are higher, on a higher level. We have many layers, you know, mountain places are like that. So he always jump on next to the tree. From the lower level, he jump. He somehow find a way to do it. Then either he climb a little bit and snap the fruit. This karob, it look like beans, you know, but black. When they're ripe, they're black. When they were not ripe, they're green. Oh, sorry, I have to look at the majority. And... he always takes some down, you know, not just one for himself, but he took a lot. He got a bunch. Either they're laying on the ground, you know, when they're ripe, they become blackened and fall down like chocolate color. Just so they don't know what kind of color. It's good that you sit nearby, yeah. And he would take down a big bunch of them, yeah, and share with, you know, Lucky, Benny, Happy, you know, they're good at. Goody don't like this thing. But the other three share, especially Lucky, oh, he keep eating and eating and then ask for more, and then Hermit has to try to climb the tree again. Because the tree these trees are not very tall and not very massive. They're just kind of similar to apple trees, you know? And he could kind of jump up a little bit and then snatch one from his mouth or paw it down, no? If nothing more on the ground, he'd do that. And then first he give it to Lucky. Oh, such a nice gentleman he was. Yeah, the more I think about him, the more I love him so much. So I don't know what I want to tell you. Okay. I wrote a lot of things that you don't even need. But here, for example, this is too long ago, yeah? May, so I'm looking for the nearest one that I have written down something. By June then, huh? June, for example, June 1st, huh? At that time, I'm not in retreat, so I wrote more often. You see, like every 2-3 days, I check out. So, <Wow. laughs> I check out how much I have, you know? And how I check out all kind of things. Sometimes I check out people. Because some special event, yeah, I check out. And then like 29th of May, and then 30th of May, I have written down, for example, how much nutrition reorientation that I have brought down, for example, how much percentage of power, you know, in more or less relatively compared to our world, the standards of our world. But in heaven, there are no such thing as kilogram, kiloliter, or, you know, I don't have measurements. But I try to fit it into our framework of intellectual understanding, yeah? So, like, I translate all the names of the store, supply store, into English. Otherwise, I don't remember a thing myself, let alone even telling you what name it is. Yeah, it's easier for me in English, yeah? But it's very difficult sometimes, you know, try to remember. And sometimes have to go back up there and then translate and bring it back down again. That's why I told you just one bed, one place, and it took me 3 days. 3 days and three nights as well, no? But not the whole night. No? Of course, I meditate and do it. But it took me 3 days. And three nights, you know, do and meditate, you know, to complete all the list, because I forgot where the, for example, peace from God, where is God's love, where is love like God's life, for example, the position, yeah. Also, for beginning, I wrote a lot. Later, I get smarter. You know, I was too excited, but later I get smarter. I draw maps. It's easier, but that was in beginning was more difficult. Because in the whole big room, for example, a whole big living room, there's only a couple of them. And I don't know how to do exactly. At that time, it was kind of too exact, you know. I think I have to measure from the door to there, how many millimeter from here to there, how many centimeter. I got tired, so I thought I'd just write it, describe it, you know, next to the sofa, next to the chimney, in the middle of the walkway or whatever that is, you're near the kitchen, whatever, you know? And so, for example, and on the 31st of May, is any nearer than that? June? Yeah. In June 10, is the nearest that we get. After that, I don't do it anymore up to now. In June 10, we have like... But this is a measurement that above zillions of zillions of zillions. Remember, I told you I have to invent a different kind of mathematic system in order to count it, like A1, A2, and the AB, and then B1, B2... This is above all you can imagine number, yeah? It's just so that I can focus on something, so that to measure my progress and just to measure the power relatively. So, for example, here, On the 10th of June, karmic immunity for me at that time, without retreat, without seeing you, it was 11,000¾%. Yeah? And that will last me 3,000 plus days, more than 3,000 days. Yeah? For example, after 3 days, the 13th of June, I have 12,000%. And it lasts me also 3,000 days plus. Yeah, for example. And some other time, I think it lasts more than that. But as the first few days of group meditation, whoop, it go down, zoom. Oh, I was so scared. I immediately forget all about the peace or whatever. I go to the karmic immunity first. Because I don't want anything happen. I promise all these weeks to be with you, and if something happened to me, I can't be here. It goes so fast. I remember where it was. I wrote it somewhere. I'm sure I did. Even if you happen to have my book, I don't think you understand anything about what I'm doing here. You see what I mean? Yeah. You will not understand what I'm doing. Oh, here. July 15. I wrote something here. Because disciples, karmas, and world karma is so scary. I said. What's happening in sex swarm in the cave? TV kaput. Air condition leaks, dogs troubling all day, all night, dogs sick. I feel empty of everything and dead tired. Okay, that's a very nice thing to read. I wrote it in red so that I don't miss it. Because I just discovered that my karmic immunity just go down, so almost zero, you know. Only 10 days left, something like that, so I had to catch up quickly. That's why I wrote it like that. But I have written somewhere where my karmic immunity go down, but I can't find it anymore. This is like a, you know, Greek, ancient Greek literature, yeah, map or whatever. But if I have time, I could understand all this and translate it out for you, but you don't need to know all that. Okay, so we forget that for now, eh? That was, if anything important, I tell you. But sometimes I write it backward, you understand? Yeah, because I don't have the space afterward. Or maybe I wrote it wrong sometime. 15th of July, I wrote it 15th of June because I forgot to turn the next page and I thought, okay, this is continue. It's not like that, nah? Now, on the 10th of, 10th of June, we have here karmic immunity for me already, I told you, nah? And then nutrition reorientation. I brought it out 500+%, and it would last for 115 years. If the at that time for that kind of world, and no more newborn, no more new initiated, and all that, then it would last 115 years. But it will dispense so quick because the bad karma covered it. So it's not like whatever I brought down, it will stay that way. So I have to continue to, replenish it, yeah? Okay. And for peace, we have 1,822%, and it would last for 158 years if the world stands still at that moment and no more nothing new, no more killing, no more war, then peace would be present for 158 years. But unluckily, the world changed all the time. You see what I mean? So even how much power I brought down, I still have to continue. It's not enough. They still continue killing, and then they nullify this power. See what I mean? The negative power will take it, erase it. It just absorbs in the karmic pattern of the world. The reality is different than what I bring down. You see what I mean? Like, for example, you're very rich parents, and you go to the bank and get $100,000 out and give it to your children. Unfortunately, they go out and squander it right away, you know, drug, alcohol, and whatever, fighting each other and do all kind of things, or smash the cars or whatever, and it's gone in no time. Yeah? Doesn't mean that the father did not bring out $100,000 and give it to the children. He did do it. Just the children did not stay and save it. They go out and squander it right away. Understand that? Same with all the power that I brought down. Now, the universe stability, I brought it down 1,000+%. At that day, huh? Up to that day. I mean, not immediately that day, but it built up for many days already until then, huh? And it could last 1,000+ years. Wow. And for example, return spiritual power, I have 835,000 for myself at that day, and it will last me more than 1,000 years. But it won't last. Right. You know that, okay? Yeah. The $100,000 won't last, yeah. The children spend so fast. But it's better than nothing, you know? Without that $100,000, they probably couldn't cover the insurance. They probably have to go to jail, okay? Then pro-life, produce life. Then it's at that time, just by the way, because in the one group, you know, so I sit and some of it I profit. Yeah, by the way, you know, like karmic immunity and other thing, and the rest are for the world. Yeah, at that time I have regained so much youth power that I could return to 25 years of age myself. But that won't last either. See, I'm wrinkling all over. Yeah. That's just for that day, yeah? And if I'm not a master, if I don't carry on initiation, if I don't have disciples yelling my name every day or the world, then I would return as the youthful age of 25, or even the next day, 21 years. Wow. Next 3 days, 13th of June, that's the power of youth quell or produce youth or produce life. They have all kind of things, produce life, produce youth, similar. Yeah. Make you healthy, young, and vigorous, yeah? Your blood pure, your skin smooth, and your hair stop graying and go back to normal again, like when you're 21. Or even younger if you continue like that. But it won't last by me. This is just by the way, just to tell you. It won't last. Of course, if I have time, continue to sit in that position, in that place, then I would keep the appearance, yeah? But there's so much thing to do. I couldn't bother about that. And I told you already, I don't want to live long. Not more than normal, okay? Once I've done my job, I'll be happy to say sayonara. Yeah, for example, like that, huh? And I brought 80% plus zillions of love into the world, huh? But you know what I mean, yeah? Okay, on 19 and 20 of June, yeah, continue a little bit more. I wrote here like karmic immunity, 38,000. It will last 8,000 days, yeah? And peace in the world, I brought down 3,830%. it could last 200 years? Yes, but it won't last that long. Return spiritual power, well, yeah, okay, I got that. 2,742%. What's this? Yeah, similar stuff. Not much important. Okay. Now, I want to tell you something interesting. You see all this kind of thing I wrote here? Map, small map, because I don't need a big map anymore. You see, oh, this is a chimney. A funny chimney, huh? Mm. I just have to write a map to show where that position is. Like, this is a chimney, yes, and God's light is right in the middle, almost right in the middle of it, in front of it. You see what I mean? And here is the living room door, and next to it is the absolute control. For example, like that. I just wrote it so that I don't forget. Of course, I can check it again, but it's tiring, huh? Mm. So every time I pass by, I want to know where, and I just look at the map. Every day, not every day, but every now and then, a different map. In the beginning, was very difficult. Like in one room, it's very difficult to find out where things are. Or in a big garden, it's difficult. Of course, my dogs helped, huh? But only a smaller level. Mm. A bigger level, higher level, I had to find out myself. And it takes a lot of concentration. A lot of hours of research and meditation, huh? Concentration is important. And almost every day I just write how much I have, or maybe new discovery, new divine connection somewhere, or how much I have earned during the day or the night or many hours, it depends. Huh? I wrote it down. Okay, so there's not much. Now I'm going to tell you something interesting. I even have time to write the song for God. Well, almost what you know already, yeah, but it's a little different lyric, no? Maybe different, or maybe I have forgotten what I have sung before, because mostly is spontaneous, so maybe I repeated it, I don't know. Like, this, like, 'cause God is love, and love is all, and has loved us, in God we trust, and God loves us, in love we trust, in love we grow, in love we glow. Infinite love from God above. We are children of God and love. We are children of God and love. We are children of God and love. And then, forevermore has loved us all. Forevermore we love him so. The love above, the love below, is all God's love. In God we love. Actually, I just wrote it for, you know, this universal love, yeah, for universal God's love, yeah. When I'm so thankful of all this rediscovery and all the help and the guidance of all heavens, I need a lot of help. All heavens were helping me. I couldn't find it all by myself. Because into the higher realm, I need protection. From the physical standpoint, you know, when you go up, it's not like that easy, yeah? So they all help me. Yes, while I'm ascending, they're helping everyone that can, everyone nearby. All help a lot. I wish in the physical world I have so much help. But the karma of this world don't allow it. Yeah? So I have maybe one or two assistants. All right, tell you something more. I want to tell you something here. I just read it, okay? In the extreme cosmic region, when was that? That's on 17th of May, 2013. Apart from all the things that I wrote, like how much peace we have, how much, love, how much, whatever, yeah. And there is another thing that I know here that I wanted to share with you, because I didn't tell on TV. I didn't say in the interview with the Supreme Master TV staff. Okay. In the extreme cosmic region, spiritual so-called supply store, the store, is like 150 square meters each. And the entrance is only 10 inches wide and 1.5 meter long. Only the soul can come in. I think you can't come in. Maybe Jean can. I can if I don't keep eating too much. I can drag my body in there. Compared to this physical dimension, it is like that. But it's endless. You know, even when you come there, you see like almost like 10 inches wide and 0.5 meter long, the entrance. But it's not like that, you know. Once you enter, it's like immense sky in there. But actually, it's only 150 square meters for each store, for each section, like for peace, for life, for youth, for karmic immunity, etc., etc. They're all very square up there, huh? Square. Right. And then the connection which you can reach, which you can tune into in this physical world, but not, of course, you cannot see it right here. What I mean is, when you live in this physical world, if you want to connect to this storehouse up there in the cosmic extreme region, there is a tube, like a water pipe, similar. Yeah, it's about 0.5 meter long and 10 centimeter wide. That's about this much. Yeah? So I don't know how you get in. This much long. About this wide. So zoop, the soul goes in. Like a straw halm, no? Yeah. And even then, it's not always open, eh? It's only open when I come in. Or whenever the guardians want to drip a few drops of this blessing down into this planet. More into the universe, you know, that's it. Normally it's closed all the time and guarded tightly. No power can ever open it. No power in the universe can ever open it, except for the guardians and the master who's supposed to be there. Occasionally, yeah. But this little tube that we have just mentioned is compact with powerful spiritual blessing of all kind, eh? And the guardians, they work in shift also. Yeah, they don't work all day or night, huh? They have shifts, like us, huh? And because also very tough to handle this power. It has to be exact, understand? Otherwise you destroy the world, or you destroy the master even into powder, huh? It's like atomic room, key or control board. You have to be exact. So they work in shift, about 4 shifts every day. Our day, yeah. And there's no day, no night over there, but they take turn to do that. And every 7 years, they change equip. Change, huh? James God, yes, like a Buckingham Palace. No. Okay, so I think that's maybe interesting for you. Yeah, that's it. Yeah. I know I wrote a lot here, but it's nothing really important to you. I just wrote down where things are, you know. For example, what is that? For example, something I write, SM only, means it's only for me. And W and uni mean for world and for the universe. Mostly because I'm physically here, the main office here. So the world benefit more than the universe, like last time I told you, for an example already, yeah? So I just wrote down, like, review the universe. It's in a window, middle, terrace, door, yeah, for example. Who would even find it? Orange carpet on the right. The other one, eh? Multi-spirit power. Orange carpet. Orienting spiritual levels also. That's just not for you. It's in a bedroom door front, for example, like that. Yeah. But it's not here, huh? Okay? It's in another country. I left it for you. Okay. Any more questions? Are there some people upstairs also?
Yes.
They couldn't sit here. So I don't have to go up and talk to them later. hey, listen. You want to hear some jokes? Joke is always good, huh? Yeah. Okay. Last time we cracked a few. I had a joke today, original, but I forgot what it is already. I forgot. If I don't write out, I forget. That's why I wrote a lot in the beginning. Hair, right? Hair like a rabbit. Hair. Oh, man, don't they have better pronunciation? Everything hair, hair. You know, hair appearance, hair of fortune, huh? And my hair and the hair running around. Yeah, too many in one pronunciation, huh? And some people don't talk English very well. They say, come here. Yeah. What are you doing here? Here, okay. A man and his wife were taking a Sunday drive when a hare, you know, a large rabbit, jumps out into the middle of the road. Oh. He swears to avoid hitting it, but unfortunately, the hare jumps right in front of the car. Oh, man, he must feel very depressed. No carrot that day. The supermarket is empty of carrots or something. So maybe he wants to dine, eh? The driver and his wife pull over and get out to see what has become of the rabbit. Much to the husband's dismay, the rabbit is dead. Oh. I continue, okay, here. Yeah. The wife pulls out a spray can. She walks over to the limp, dead rabbit, bends down, and sprays the contents onto the rabbit. The hare jumps up, waves his paw at the two of them and hops off down the road. 10 feet away, the rabbit stops, turns around, and waves again. He hops down the road another 10 feet, turns and waves again. Hops another 10 feet, turns and waves again. And he repeats again and again until finally he hops out of sight. Wow, what a polite rabbit. We human wave once, that's already sufficient. I'm already tiring enough. The man is astonished. Me too. Huh? He asks his wife, what was that in that can? What did you spray on that rabbit? The wife turns the can around so that her husband can read the label. It says on the label, hairspray. Can restore life to dead hair and adds permanent wave. That
very cute. I didn't expect that.
Actually, yesterday is supposed to be the last day of retreat, you know, so we could laugh today, huh? That we survive one more day, see? So we have a cause to celebrate, huh? I don't know if this is a good one. Atheist, yeah? Mm. An atheist. You know what an atheist is, yeah? Yeah, you don't believe in God, right? Okay. An atheist was walking down a road along a precipice. Suddenly, the stones under his feet crumbled away and he fell over the cliff. Is that a joke? Oh, there's some more. Okay. Just over the edge, a small tree growing on the rocks stopped his fall. Hanging onto it with one hand, he thought, well, I have nothing to lose if I pray. Do you hear me, O Lord? The atheist shouted out. All of a sudden, the voice answered, I do. Save me, O Lord, and I will believe in you. The voice came back, no, I will not. You all say the same thing when you are in trouble. But afterwards, you do not believe. So the man was desperate. Please, please, truly, I will believe in you. I swear it. There is done. I believe in you. Okay, God say, very well. The voice say, very well, I will save you. Now let go of the branch. The man replied, what? Do you think I'm an idiot? This, we had it before, but I like this version better. You can stretch your legs, guys, yeah? Especially the long, just stretch it out, you know? I make an example. This is an example. You don't do it at home, okay? Especially somebody else's home, yeah? Because you got kicked out, no? But here it's okay. It's our home. We can do what we want, both of us. Okay, silent treatment is the next. A man and his wife were having some problem at home and were giving each other the silent treatment. I think you all know that, right? Silent treatment. I never used it, but I'm sure you do. Suddenly, the man realized that the next day he would need his wife to wake him up at 5 a.m. for an early morning business flight. Silly man. He has an alarm clock. He has a phone, right? Probably. This is a long time ago, no? Yeah, when they did not invent the clock yet, no? Or this guy, he didn't invent his brain yet. Not wanting to be the first to break the silence and lose, so he wrote on a piece of paper, please wake me at 5 a.m. He left the paper where he knew his wife would find it. You know already, right? You know what happened, right? The next morning, the man woke up only to discover it was 9 a.m. already, and he had missed his flight. Very, very annoyed. He was about to go and see why his wife had not awakened him when he noticed a piece of paper by the side of the bed. You know already. It is written, it's 5 a.m., wake up. You know it already, why you laugh so loud only when I say it. Nice. Good joke, huh? Okay. Bah. Okay, now I just remember the joke that I want to tell you. I even wrote a joke here, so. Yeah. Sometimes it comes, you know, in the middle of nowhere. And when I'm that serious sitting for world peace, it comes a joke. It jump out. So it's like this, one of the jokes. I think maybe I have told you already. There's a couple of jokes. Or maybe I didn't tell you. Never mind. Pretend that you didn't hear, even if you did. And laugh, okay? Otherwise, you get no more joke for me. A man come move into his new house in the new neighborhood. Yes. A cheaper rent, and he just divorced, and what else he do? Yeah. And then the plumber came and fixed the stuff for him. And the new man asked the plumber, They told me that water here is not fit to drink from the tap. What do you suggest we drink, that I should drink? He said, beer. Okay, because I had some plumber come and fix my pipe, and then I think that the joke came from there. Even a plumber can trouble me. Okay, now bar, because I see bar here, you know, drinking bar. A man goes into a bar and drinks beer. After every glass of beer, he pulls a picture out of his pocket and look at it. After the fourth beer, the waiter asks him why. After every glass of beer, he pulls a picture out and look at it. Why? The man says, it's a picture of my wife. When she looks good to me, I'm going home. I don't see anything. Oh, man. Why bother, huh? Yes, yes, it's true. Sometimes you marry a person and you don't see the ugly side until later on. Not just physical, but inside. Huh? In Vietnam, we say, if you stay awake long, then you know how long the night is. Yeah. And if you ride a horse long, then you know how strong he is, something like that. You never know, huh? Never know your partner. Refrigerator is another joke. Huh? Refrigerator one. Why? He has two? A man was telling his friend he went home to find his wife has left a note on the fridge. The note said, it's not working, I can't take it anymore, so I have gone to stay at my mom's. Our usual stuff, no? We hear that all the time. The man said to his friend, I opened the fridge, the light came on, and the beer was still cold. What is she talking about? I thought it was a fridge myself. Yeah. Okay. The next joke. Why are married women heavier than single women? Huh?
Right.
Huh? Single women come home, see what's in the fridge and go to bed. Married women come home, see what is in bed and go to the fridge. Is that true? Why is that? Why you have to check the bed first?
Just a reminder. Oh, that's all there is. Well, maybe there's something better in the fridge.
Okay. Some substitute, no? Cha-cha. But everybody married, why? And they can't even leave. They always threaten divorce, but they stay together forever, you know. I mean, some do, but mostly stay forever, no? And endure all kind of control or trouble or manipulation or boring relationship, no? And still stay together. Ah, tell me why, Choco. Karma. Wow, good. Good one, huh? So quick. Now, okay, these are rules for men to follow if they want a happy life. Listen, guys. Only for you, huh? Now I really concentrate here. I'm on your side. Yeah? Number one. It's important to have a woman who helps at home, cooks from time to time, cleans up, and has a job. Number two, it's important to have a woman who can make you laugh. I'm right here. I'm an ideal woman, no? Yeah, I cook from time to time. I cleans up my house, my own house, and I has a job. Yeah, how come I'm single? God knows. Yeah. And I make you laugh as well, no? Number three, it's important to have a woman who you can trust and doesn't lie to you. You can trust me. I don't lie to you. That's for sure, right? Oh, it sounds like I have 4 points already. Close to ideal woman. Yeah, yeah. Number five. And finally, it's very important that these four women do not know each other. Otherwise, you are a dead man. Oh, man. I was thinking. Make a joke of us. Terrible. This must be woman hater. Driving license. My neighbor was working in his yard when he was startled by a car that came crashing through his hedge and ended up in his front lawn. He rushed to help the elderly lady driver out of the car and sat her down on a chair. After asking if she was okay, he said, "You appear quite elderly to be driving." The woman said, "Well, yes, I am," proudly. "I'll be 97 next month, and I'm now old enough that I don't need a driver's license anymore." Really? After 90, they don't give you driver license anymore, right? Oh, how convenient. Then I wait until I'm 90, then I just drive. Well, you don't give me a driver license. What am I to do, right? The last time I went to my doctor, he examined me and asked if I had a driver's license. I told him yes and handed it to him. He took a pair of scissors out of the drawer, cut the license into pieces, and threw them in the wastebasket, saying, "You won't need this anymore." So I thanked him and left. It means you're too old, you shouldn't drive anymore. And then she said, "Oh, it's very good, thank you." She thinks the doctor said, "Okay, you're okay now. You can drive without license." It wasn't very funny, but never mind. Two women talking in heaven. Oh, wow, interesting. That's probably for you. No? Don't listen. Woman talks, yeah? Two women are talking in heaven. First woman say, "Hi, my name is Wanda." The second woman, "Hi, my name is Siva. How did you die?" The first woman, "I froze to death." The second woman, "How horrible." First woman, "Oh, it wasn't so bad. After I stopped shaking from the cold, I began to get warm and sleepy and finally die a peaceful death. What about you?" A second woman said, "I died of a massive heart attack. I suspected that my husband was cheating, so I came home early to catch him in the act, but instead I found him all by himself in the den watching TV." So the first woman say, "Oh, so what happened?" Second woman, "I was so sure there was another woman there somewhere that I started running all over the house looking for her. I ran up into the attic and searched and down into the basement, and then I went through every closet and checked under all the beds. I kept this up until I had looked everywhere, and finally I became so exhausted that I just knew over with a heart attack and died." The first woman comment, "It's too bad for you. Didn't look in the freezer." Oh, we would both still be alive. Oh, man. She should have looked in the freezer. And both women still be alive. But I like the punchline. Thai salesman. A man desperate for water was plodding through the desert when he saw something far off in the distance. Hoping to find water, he hurried toward the mirage. Mirage. Sounds like French. Yeah, maybe it's French. Only to find a little old man standing at a small table selling ties. The man asked, "Do you have any water?" The salesman replied, "I have no water. Would you like to buy a tie? They are only $5. The man shouted hysterically, "You idiot! I do not need an overpriced adornment. I need water." "Sorry, I have none. Just ties. Only $5. The guy was very angry now. "I should wrap one around your neck and choke you, but I must save my energy and find water," said the little old man, the tie sellers. "Okay, it doesn't matter that you do not want to buy a tie for me or that you threaten my life. I will show you that I am bigger than all that. If you continue over that hill to the east for about 2 miles, you will find a restaurant. It has the finest food and all the ice-cold water you need." The desperate man staggered away over the hill. Several hours later, he crawled back, almost dead. The old man said, "Did you find the restaurant?" The man answered, "Yes, but they won't let me in without a tie." First-class restaurant. Yes, yeah, some restaurant demand that you have to go in with the proper attire, you know. You can't go in with flip-flop shoes. You can't go in without a tie and a suit. In some hotels like that. And business is business. They have a store next door to sell you suit or rent you tie or to rent you suit or rent you tuxedo, whatever. Yeah? They make business for them also, you see? That's very clever, eh? This entrance don't let you in without a tie or a suit or tuxedo. Next door is so conveniently. Yeah. There's a store for rent or buy or that. It's truly like that. Like in Hotel de Paris in Monaco. I don't remember what occasion. But a man cannot come in without a suit. So he has to go next door and rent one. Rent a jacket. Yeah. And a tie. And did I tell you that joke about the invitation? It's a posh upper class birthday party, and the invitation is written. I said, "Please come with tights and dancing shoe." So a man come just with that, just with tights and dancing shoe. Okay, guys, I have to go.
Please tune in to the next session of this international gathering with Supreme Master Ching Hai and our association members. To be notified when a new session is available, subscribe to Supreme Master Television's newsletter at www.suprememastertv.com/newsletter.
Supreme Master Ching Hai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For a free-of-charge guidance, please visit www.godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Be vegan. Make peace. For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com.